Well, folks, I want you to listen carefully during this hour. And right now, I'm going to issue a call to all Americans who believe in and care for the Constitution and the Bill of Rights and understand the importance of the founding of this nation and the importance of saving it. I am calling for all Americans to organize the militia in their cities, in their towns, in their rural areas. I am calling upon you to arm yourselves. I am calling upon you to muster and meet and show those in power that we're serious. Deadly serious. This is a call to arms. I want you to listen carefully, ladies and gentlemen, for freedom hangs in the balance today, not tomorrow, today. Your freedom hangs in the balance. Today, right now, as we speak, at least 16 gun ban bills have been introduced in Congress. One has already passed the United States Senate as part of its crime bill, and there will be more. They will flood the House and the Senate with bills to ban the right to keep and bear arms by the American people. Some bills ban long guns. Others ban handguns. Some go after all of our weapons. No matter what kind of gun you own, sooner or later your gun will be on someone's ban list, if it isn't already. The anti-gunners also want to tell you what types of ammunition you can own, and what size magazines you can own, and there are measures before the House and the Senate to heavily tax ammunition. They want you to believe that disarming law-abiding citizens will make you and your family safer, and nothing could be farther from the truth. In the cities in this nation, where there is a 100% ban on citizens owning any weapons, they have the highest murder rate, the highest crime rate, the highest statistics of death by crime that's ever existed in this nation. Gun ban bills now in the United States Congress are S-108, bans many imported guns. S-639, bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. S-653, bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. Now, I don't mean mini rifles like M-I-N-I. I mean mini rifles like M-A-N-Y. S-892 bans all handguns. S-1607 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. H.R. 893 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. H.R. 1421 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. H.R. 1472 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. H.R. 1501 bans all handguns. H.R. 1568 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. H.R. 1571 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. H.R. 1706 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. H.R. 1734 bans many handguns. H.R. 3132 bans all handguns. H.R. 3184 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. H.R. 3527 bans many rifles, shotguns, and handguns. And there is a bill in the Rules Committee that is coming out on the floor of the House within the next few days that will ban all semi-automatic weapons in the nation. You had better wake up, for when the last gun leaves the last hand of the last honest American, it will be the end of freedom in the entire world. Not just in America, but in the entire world. You can stop this assault upon your Creator-endowed rights, protected by the Constitution and the Bill of Rights, on your freedom to keep and bear arms. You can tell your congressman that you refuse to be blamed for the violent acts of criminals. You can tell your congressman that you are sick and tired of being told to justify your need to own this or that. Remind your congressman that in America, we have a Bill of Rights, not a Bill of Needs. Technically, according to a ruling by the Executive and Justice Departments of the United States government, we are under the law of the United Nations Charter and the resolutions passed by the United Nations. This is no longer the land of the free, and I am beginning to wonder if it is the home of the brave. Understand what I am telling you. The Constitution of the United States of America states that the militia, being necessary to a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. The law specifically states that the militia is all men and boys between the ages of 17 and 45. They're required to own a weapon and at least 100 rounds of ammunition. Gun legislation is against the Constitution. It is unconstitutional. The Senate ruled in 1981 that the military is not the militia, that the National Guard is not the militia, that the militia is constituted by the whole of the people. By the whole of the people. By the whole of the people. The Arizona State Constitution says that the militia, the unorganized militia, is all men and boys between the ages of 17 and 45. The Arizona State Constitution forbids taking the guns away from the people. Specifically states that Arizona state citizens have a right to keep and bear arms with no strings attached. So all gun legislation, specifically gun legislation, which would take weapons out of the hands of those who under the law constitute the militia, is unconstitutional and illegal. You must form militia units now. You must organize now. You must forbid anyone who has ever been convicted of a felony from serving in your militia unit. You must have strict regulation. You must elect officers. You must swear allegiance to the Constitution and the Bill of Rights to protect and defend the Constitution and the Bill of Rights against all enemies, foreign and domestic, and you must do this now. You must form publicly, with weapons, under the law, and you must drill at least one day a month in public, with weapons. All weapons must be inspected. They must not be loaded with ammunition, although militia members may have ammunition on their person. You must do this. You must inspect your state constitutions and your state laws. You must organize your militia legally within the law. You must do this now. It will not be long, dear listeners, before they have to make overt moves to put into place the control of each individual citizen. They have named this as the year that they will disarm the American people completely, 100%. This is the year that they have named for the completion of the total disarmament of the American people. Whether or not they are successful will depend upon you.